In this video, we'll talk about paradoxical embolism. In embolism, embolus, which is also called as blood clot or the mass, it flows through the blood vessels. It lodges at one point, decreasing the blood supply at that point and oxygen supply at that point, creating the ischemic conditions and may lead to infarction as the time passes. So this is called as embolism. It is the flow of embolus in the circulation, leading to an obstruction. Later, infarction might also be seen. So now, the paradoxical embolism, it is rare, and it is the flow of embolism along the circulation, that is from venous to arterial or vice versa. Embolus moves from right to left side of the heart without passing through the lungs. That is why it is called as paradoxical. So normally, it won't pass from right side to the left side directly. But we can see this in case of patent foramen ovale or defective septum. Now let's talk about flow of embolus. Suppose if the patients have blood clot in the pelvic region or the leg region, through the IVC that clot can come to the right atrium. And from the patent foramen ovale, it reaches the left atrium. From the left atrium, it reaches the left ventricle. It creates an obstruction in the systemic circulation. In severe cases, renal infarction or gastrointestinal infarction can also be seen. In some other cases, from the left ventricle, this embolus reaches the aorta, then it reaches the brain. There, it causes the obstruction, and in severe cases, sudden death can also occur due to the cryptogenic shock. So, examples, this is seen in the patients of patent foramen ovale and the defective septum patients. Complications, it is shock and sudden death in case of severe obstruction in the brain. Diagnosis is a radiological imaging. Treatment is embolectomy, that is the removal of the embolus, and surgical closure of the patent foramen ovale. So here you can see the PFO occluder. So this is about paradoxical embolism.